नमस्ते डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज आवर न्यू सीरीज विच वी आर कॉलिंग इट एज द संकल्प सीरीज. दिस इज द सेकेंड वीडियो इन आवर संकल्प सीरीज एंड द ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ संकल्प इज नॉट टू ट्रेन यू फॉर कॉम्पिटिटिव एग्जाम, इज नॉट अबाउट मेकिंग मनी, इट इज नॉट अबाउट स्कोरिंग मार्क्स, इट इज ऑल अबाउट थिंकिंग अबाउट आवर सेल्व्स. Now I have decided to come up with this Sankalpa series as part of our YouTube channel videos to make students or to make people more stronger, and by making you stronger I also want to become stronger myself. And with this logic I am here with this Sankalpa series, and the objective is basically to make you think in different dimensions about the society, about the economic systems, about the history, the way we live, the way we think, and how it is going to be in future, the most important thing. Okay, so moving forward, the topic which I have taken today for discussion is capitalism ka khatra. Now the dangers of capitalism. Now after liberalization policy, after we are totally dipped in capitalism today, now you can see the picture behind where the girl is running behind money. Now money is the most important and the motivating factor. Our role models are gods of capitalism. Now let's try to observe how the situation is changing, and we as people, we as citizens of India, we as people who inherit such great culture, how do we handle, are we really successful in handling this devil called capitalism? I'm using the word devil wantedly because it is a kind of leviathan which is going to eat its own master. That is, let's try to observe slowly what is happening. When we talk about cricket, when we talk about Sunil Gavaskar, the way cricket used to be, we see in cricket as a religion, and in fact we see players as almost like gods in India. And today in the era of capitalism we can see how the cricket has changed. You can see those fancy girls there. More than the game, the glamour which is brought in by IPL is more motivating, number one. Now in our childhood, my teacher used to always tell me, you should have delayed gratification, and your success or the way you achieve your goals depends on this concept of delayed gratification. Now do we really have this ability of delayed gratification in this era where there is so much of fancy which is visible around us? Are we really thinking? Is our brain really working, or is it that we are manipulated on a continuous basis? Our ideas, are they real ideas? Our thoughts, are they real thoughts? Or is it an interplay of forces which are beyond our thinking? Now this is something which we all have to observe. I still remember some instances. I'm a great fan of cricket. I also played for my school in my school days, and I was very much depressed when I saw Azharuddin or some of our favorite cricket stars involved in match fixing. Then I was thinking, what is this? Is money bigger than the game? Is money bigger than the game? Is something which I found. I will also share one of my very close experience of my school. I was very much inspired by my Telugu teacher. Now this Telugu master, I don't want to name him, this Telugu master used to inspire us like hell. Every day he used to talk about Bhagat Singh, he used to teach us about Subhash Chandra Bose. He was talking about how freedom struggle came in 6th standard, 7th standard. But one day in my adjacent house, there was a very rich businessman who was living, and I could see my Telugu master coming there and teaching those kids by taking a meager tuition amount. Now, this incident also has pricked my heart very badly. Is it that this Telugu teacher not financially sufficient, whom I seem as God, can be moved by the forces of money? Now, this was something which in my initial days, in my childhood days, has got imprinted in my mind. And I was thinking continuously, what is this? Money can move anything. Money can move everything, in fact. Is this true? Is this a fact? Now, this is something which, now, yes, do agree that money can move everything. Then, sir, then why are we preparing for some government job? As a civil servant, you are a salaried employee. Then are you going to dance to the tunes of capitalism, or are you going to stand and fight for the values which you have? Now, this is a question which I don't know how many of you would have thought. Everybody should have ego. Everybody should have self-respect. Now, your self-respect, is it going to be diminished when you become corrupt? When some big entity comes and tells you, why can't you sign this particular project because you have taken money? Are we becoming lifeless, or are we bending our heart and soul for this one big master called money? Now, this experience why I shared of my Telugu teacher is basically because I used to have great respect for him. It's not that I've lost my respect that because he was coming and teaching those rich kids. But I didn't feel, the feeling was not good for me to see my master bend and sit in front of them and teach for a meager tuition fees. Now, this is something like a dilemma which keeps to keep running in my mind. Now, how to become master? Is it by earning money? Then what should I do? Now, coming to India. Now, you guys who are going to be bureaucrats, now you can see these pictures. On one side, you have huge amount of poverty and starvation. On the other side, we have these cheer girls, poor girls, cheering out to the masters of capitalism. Is the game got destroyed? You have gods of capitalism on the other side. You have the gods of capitalism here. On the other side, you have Elon Musk, you have Mark Zuckerberg there, and you have the Amazon owner. So, on the other side, we have our stars, superstars here. Now, what is it all happening? Did you ever observe, is the question. Did you ever think? Now, when you are running for something, when you feel your, today, if you see who's your role model, my role model is, let's say, Elon Musk or Mark Zuckerberg. How do you define success? Success is defined in terms of earning billions of dollars. Shah Rukh Khan is successful. He runs his own team. Okay, now this is how you are defining success. Then Vijay Mallya was seen as highly successful. I still remember there was one IPL match where Rahul Dravid was not playing. And I could still recollect the words of Vijay Mallya those days. We are paying money. What is the problem? Is talent getting surrendered to money? Now just keep thinking on these things. Or in this present scenario, is it wrong to hold the power of money? Now, these are the thoughts which should be coming to everybody's mind. Now, I personally feel the role of a civil servant or a politician comes here in a developing country because there is a huge gap between those who are starving and those who are making people starve. There's this gap between those who are really starving without nutrition and those who are making people starve. Here I'm talking about Vijay Mallya. I'm not talking about Facebook owner here, but I'll come to Facebook owner a little while later. So these are people who are making people starve, and you also have people who are starving on the other side. Now, in justice, who is going to bring justice then? Then what is justice? So there's nothing like justice. What I believe is justice. This is what you think, then probably you are not apt for my video. Now, here what I want to tell you is, how do you balance? What should you do? So then you say, sir, we have to leave all these dollars and become poor. Not at all. Not at all. That's not the idea. I'm not asking you all to leave dollars and just live as a poor man or die poor. This is not my objective. You have to become rich. No doubt about it. No doubt about it. Now see the burden of dollars which they are bearing. Now just think, when we go and vote in elections, is our election, our voting pattern decided based on our thinking, or is it decided based on feelings? Remember, all elections, referendums are based on human feelings. And we all feel that our feelings are innate. It is our own, coming from inner consciousness. And therefore, your decision is always right. This is how we think. Remember, we are wrong. In the era of capitalism, in the era of machine intelligence, there is nothing like free will. A simple example which I want to share with you all is, you want to find out the best store in your area. How do you do it? Are you going to go do the research, or is it the Google algorithm which will decide the best shop for you, the best saloon for you, the best academy for you? It is the Google algorithm that is deciding. It is not your brain. Just observe. Even when you're Netflix, when you're trying to search for the next movie, it is the algorithm which will tell you, these are the things you like. You don't need to think. You just have to select one among these. Your choice is not about free will. Tomorrow, if a Coca-Cola wants to sell a product, now when you're watching this, it can easily identify, the algorithm can easily identify where your eyelids are moving. If your eyelids are moving towards these girls out here, probably they know that the Coca-Cola bottle should have girls wrapped up to sell the bottle to you. And if you are probably, of course, if he's a gay person, a gay probably, based on the eyelid shift towards our superheroes down, probably the Coca-Cola will decide that the bottle should be wrapped with boys to sell it. Now, this is something the capitalism can do. It's not about you watching television. It is about the television watching you. It is what you think is you are taking your own decision, but basically your decisions are manipulated. You are not the owner of your decision. You are not the owner of your free will. You are continuously manipulated on through social media. You are continuously manipulated through different channels. Now, there's nothing like free will. Now, talking about individualism, capitalism talks about individualism. You talk about privacy. But the aspect is, do you think really privacy exists? You can see this diagram, okay, and you can see this the mobile there. Okay, you are completely public now. Your data is completely sold for dollars. Now, this is what you should understand. You are in a cage. You are surrounded in a cage, expecting you will make it big, trying to achieve success which is defined by somebody, running around and slogging for something which you feel which is really, which will make you happy, which is valid for you. And that validation is not your validation. That validation is done by some capitalist outside. Just try to understand this. Now, sir, then what we should do, sir? We should leave everything and go to forest? Then we should die poor? Nobody should die poor, because the whole logic is, you would have born poor, but you should never die poor, because it's in your hand to become rich. I don't doubt your ability to become rich. I'm not saying becoming rich is bad. You have to become rich, no doubt about it. But try to observe the clutches you are building around yourself in this process. In the era of capitalism, what are we doing? Just try to observe. See here, your thoughts are basically manipulated. You can observe this. The button press, your idea is not your idea. Your ambition is not your ambition. Your feeling is not your feeling. Your feelings can be monitored and tapped by artificial intelligence. Your desires can be modeled based on the capitalist. This is what you have to observe. And somebody at the top who is churning dollars is making people sweat for his dollars. You should understand these. You should understand and try to assimilate these things and observe these things. Are we becoming a slave to the policies of capitalism? Are we becoming a slave to principles of capitalism? Is market or businessmen deciding our life, our privacy, what we should do, our voting patterns? Everything is decided by somebody. Then how do you say there is liberty? How do you say there is individualism? These are the aspects which are the bedrock principles of capitalistic countries. You say liberty, freedom, individualism. Now in the era of artificial intelligence, your decisions are based or manipulated. Your emotions are manipulated. Your feelings are manipulated. This is what you should observe. There's nothing like liberty. There's nothing like free will unless and until. See, these are the dangers of capitalism. A small diagram which shows that how capitalism is trying to hold the resources, the law, the chair, the resources, basic necessities, everything. Now, in this case, your role as youth, what are you going to do? I'll just change the color here. The color is not visible. What is your role going to be? So your role, when we're talking about in this case, now you want to be a bureaucrat. You want to be, I believe, like you want to be a politician. You want to be a businessman. Now, what is your role as youth going to be? Can you do justice to everybody? Can you do justice to the downtrodden sections? Can you do justice to people who are in need? And that is where a bureaucrat or a politician or a businessman has to think on. You are the next generation. You are going to mold things for the downtrodden sections. Now, what has to be done then? These are the dangers of capitalism then. Sir, is there a way out? Remember, we cannot remove capitalism. You cannot change the world. You can only change yourself. You have to change yourself. You cannot change the world. You have to change the way you think. You have to change. You have to conquer your senses. As our traditions keep saying, every religion talks about, you cannot be a slave to your senses. You cannot, if you are a slave to your senses, you cannot be useful for others. You cannot be a true leader. You cannot be a true leader. Now, this is something which, so the way out is, yes, earn as much as money possible. Become as powerful as possible. Develop inner strength. Develop physical and mental strength. Become strong. Do yoga. Do meditation. Do jogging. Cycle. You have to be physically and mentally fit to fight this system. You cannot be a sick individual in depression, a sick individual or a selfish individual. You cannot bring any change, any possible change. You have to become fit. Now, again, in this case, now, sir, then how is our tradition? Observe our freedom struggle. Observe people who have done it. Observe selfless people. Read their stories. Read about Elon Musk. At the same time, read Russian Revolution. Read about Mark Zuckerberg, but at the same time, understand what Swami Vivekananda has done. Unless and until you conquer your senses, unless and until you uplift your consciousness, you can have every material wealth possible, but you cannot just indulge in only material wealth. Because in the era of capitalism, the distractions are so high. Your ability to think is going to be minimum. your scope for doing welfare is going to be negligible unless and until you become stronger from inside. And that inner strength, which I call it as the core strength, which is physical as well as mental. Swami Vivekananda was talking about go play football. It's not about Bhagavad Gita. You are, unless and until you are not physically and mentally strong, you cannot fight any system. You cannot do justice to anybody, including your family. So you have to develop that mental mindset. Yes, I hold a Fortuner. I will go in Fortuner. If there is no Fortuner, I will move walking. Yes, I have crores of rupees. I'll enjoy life, possible. If there is no money, still I'm ready to face. Now, this is how we have to think. And this is the attitude which youth should develop. You have to become rich, bring in revolution, bring in innovations, come up with patents, at the same time, help people in need. This is the need of the hour. You cannot replace capitalism. You can only develop leaders. And leadership qualities have to be developed in schools. And unfortunately, school teachers are the teachers who are least paid and least respected in our country. And the whole foundation of our life is purely made or built in our schools. Highest salaries have to be given to school teachers who are building the character of the nation. Building the character of the nation. So that's all. So I want you all to work on this. And this, I wanted to give these insights just to think that you're not thinking. Just to feel that you're not feeling. Have your own feelings, having your own emotions, having your own goals, which are really yours. This is what you should be working on. Thank you. And we are coming up with more videos on Sankalpa series, which will make you think. And I hope you guys have enjoyed the video. Thank you.